Hello, this is Lisa from Happy Stamp, and today I thought I would show you how I made these little boxes that I hold my twine and my metallic threads in. They were all falling over in my drawer and just driving me crazy, so I just made a little box just to put these in, and I just thought I'd show you how I did that. So I have some of the new thread here. This is the new thread from the holiday catalog. And what you want to do is you're going to measure. And to give it a little wiggle room, I'm going to do 6 3/4. And then we're going to measure. So 6 3/4, so I have to add 2 inches, so that'll be 8 3/4. And then this is a good 1.5 inches. So we're going to add 2 onto that. And why we want to add 2 is for these pieces right here. So each one of these sides is 1 inch. So you're going to add a side, you're going to add 1 inch for each side. So it was 6 3/4. So we are going to go 8 3/4. And cut that off. And then it was 1.5, so we're going to go 3.5. And I'm using Bermuda Bay. And then we're going to take our Simply Scored. And we're going to do 1 inch on all the corners. I'm sorry, on all the sides, not all the corners. So 1 inch all the way around. Okay. And we're going to take this with our bone folder. And we're just going to give this a good crease all the way around. And I'm going to do this both ways. Okay. Now we are going to take our scissors and we're going to cut up just like this. And then I'm just going to cut in just a hair. On these tabs. Okay, and then these are just going to fold up just like that. Okay, so I'm going to take some tear and tape. And I'm just going to put a piece of tear and tape. You want to put it on the outside. Just like that. And two more pieces. That will work easier. So we're just going to take the backing off and fold that up just like that. And then there we go. There's our little box. And there you go. All right, and then just to decorate it up just a little bit, I took the, what is this called? The Brights Designer Series paper stack. And I use the Bermuda Bay again, and I'm using the stripe. Goodness. And so this is an inch here, so I'm going to cut it 3/4 of an inch, and then this is 6 3/4, just like I measured before, so I did pretty good. So I'm going to do 6 1/2 by 3/4. So I'm going to do the 3/4 first. I'm going to do that over here. Three quarters. And then your 6 1/2 is right in there. So I need two of those. I need one for each side. So 6 1/2. Okay. And then for the sides, those are going to be 3/4 by. Is this 1 1/2? Yes, 1 1/2. So those are going to be 3/4 by 1 1/4. Oh, I did 1 3/4. I need 1 1/4. Do it on this one, it's easier. So those ones I'll just save for another one. 1 1/4, not 1 3/4. and one in a corner is right here. All right. Now, just do a dry run here, make sure everything's okay. Yep. Okay, so I'm just gonna take some of our combo. That way I'll be able to wiggle it into place. And you could do these and the colors for your craft room so that it matches your room. You could do them so that they match the season. Wiggle those in place, and I kind of wiggle it around like this so I can get the glue underneath smooshed all over the place. All right. Threads back in here. You could even, if you didn't want them all separate, you could even just hook them together like this so that they're all one, but I'm going to leave them separate. So that is it for today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave me a comment below. All supplies can be purchased in my online store at www.happystamp.stampinup.net. Thanks a lot for watching and have a great day. Bye.